Hi everyone, I'm Vishnu Subramaniam from Jarvis Labs. Mistral.ai recently announced a new paper called Mixtral of Experts. They kind of did it in a reverse order. They launched their model weights as a torrent file, probably first to do that. Then they launched their code and now the paper. I think it got launched 2 days back. I have been using Mixtral for some time. I mean, I just did some experimentation when I saw a LinkedIn post, which was claiming that a specific math problem about apples, which ChatGPT-4 was not able to handle. I think Gemini was not able to handle, but Mixtral.ai was able to handle it. And I think that's the only algorithm that gave the right answer, right? It was so interesting for me. And I wanted to understand what is happening inside this Mixtral 8x7b algorithm. Right. So when the paper got released, I was excited and I started going through it. So in the video, I'm going to talk about what is the architecture of Mixtral 8x7b. And if you're someone like me who do not understand math or who are not very comfortable with jargons, I have a special section for you where I actually dig into the code for Mixtral. And I felt that looking at the code made things a lot more clearer for me than reading the paper or the blogs on Mixtral AI, right? And I mean, in the paper, there are much more content about how good it is comparing with a lot of benchmarks, whether the components of Mixtral learn a particular concept or something. Probably we'll skip that. Probably we'll keep that for another video if I can find something interesting about it. But let's stick to understanding the Mixtral 8x7b architecture, right? So there are three components in the Mixtral 8x7b architecture. It is an improvement to the Mixtral 7b model, which was earlier released. It's based on the transformer architecture, as most of the LLMs today are. One of the important layers is the feed-forward network. We'll see what exactly it is in the code in some time. They replace this feed-forward network with something called MoE, which is Mixture of Experts, right? And inside Mixture of Experts, there are two key things. There are 8 experts, which are 8 feed-forward networks, and there is a routing or gating algorithm, which decides which expert to be used. For example, let's say, "Hi, I'm Vishnu from India." This is the sentence, and each of the token goes to the routing logic or the routing algorithm, and that decides which expert to use. For example, I can go to the first and the last expert, and Vishnu can probably go to the second and the sixth expert. It kind of learns it during the entire training process. This is what happens inside the MoE layer. And it is super simple and it makes things really efficient. Let's go quickly into the code and let's try to understand what is happening in the code. So I downloaded Mixtral source repository and there is a file called model.py inside the Mixtral. So the important thing is the transformer block that we can see here. Let's open the init and this. So if you look here, if it's not an MoE model, which is the older version, then we end up using a simple feed-forward layer. If it's a Mistral, then we end up calling an MoE layer, which is a Mixture of Expert layer. Let's first start with understanding what is a feed-forward layer. If you already know a linear layer, simple things like softmax, then you understand almost the entire part of the architecture. Let's go to the feed-forward and let's see how simple it is actually. So it actually has 3 linear layers, just like most of the typical deep learning algorithms. And then they pass the first one through a nonlinear activation and the entire thing through different orders, right? So they are basically passing the input X to the first linear layer and the input X again to the third linear layer. There's a nonlinear activation, nothing much fancy. We all understand this. So if it's not the feed forward, which is if it's part of the MoE, then what we do is we call this layer called MoE layer. This particular class is being called. This particular class takes 3 arguments: experts, gate, and MoE args. I think the key things are the experts and the gate. Let's not look into the MoE args. In the experts, they're using a Python list comprehension, and they're calling the same class feedforward, which we just looked n number of times. In this case, in the paper, they used 8 as the number. So we have 8 feedforward networks, and these are going to act as experts. And then we have a gate, which is also a very simple linear function with bias as false, right? So let's now go and see what happens inside an MoE layer. That's also pretty simple. We take the inputs, which comes from the previous block. Then we pass it to the gate, which we know is a linear layer. Then we calculate the top K. We choose which two experts we want, which in the start of the training, it's usually random. Or the period of training, it learns which expert it should pick. So when you pass this gate logic, it's going to take two experts and the weights associated with it. Then we pass these weights into the softmax layer. And this is more of a bookkeeping where we create a new tensor called results with all the new values. And then I think this is where the interesting part happens. We are iterating through all the experts that we have. In this case, it's 8. And then we are picking the batches, or let's say there is a one sequence with 10 tokens. We are choosing which token has to be applied with the corresponding expert. Let's say, for example, we decided the first token has to go through expert 1 and expert 5, then that alone gets applied here. So this is also the reason why this model, though it's a larger model, 8 cross 7B, somewhere around 47 billion, is actually as fast as a 14 billion parameter for inference. The reason is it's actually utilizing only 2 experts and not all the 8 experts during the inference. This also makes it slightly complicated while training. And there are a lot of, I think one of the major contributions of the Mixtral paper is they were the first ones to successfully train a mixture of expert technique inside a transformer in the LLM in a very successful way. Though this mixture of experts is not a new invention or been invented by Mixtral.ai, it was first published probably around 1991. There was a lot of efforts from 1991 till probably 2023 trying to improve that particular technique. And Mixtral team was able to successfully bring that to transformers, and they were able to train the large language model on an undisclosed data set. The reason I'm saying it's undisclosed is I was not able to find the data set inside this paper. Now, I hope you're able to understand what exactly is MoE, what happens inside an MoE. Now, let's go and look at some of the pictures and see what are the jargon. So now I think you'll be able to understand and appreciate it in a lot better way, right? Okay, this is what we exactly were talking about. The pictorial representation, we get an input. There's a router which decides where the input should be passed to. It passes to 2 of these experts, and then it combines, it does an aggregation of the output, and the output comes, right? And there's also one critical jargon which you may hear from the paper is sparsity. The reason we call this as a sparse network rather than a dense network is a token that is being passed into this MoE layer does not go through all the expert layers. But in traditional models, it goes through all the model weights. So for example, if you pass it through older Mistral 7B, then the token, each token is going to go through all the 7 billion parameters before we get an output. But in this case, though there are 8 7B models, which is like around 47 billion, I'll share in a minute why it's actually less than 8 into 7. It actually goes through only 2 experts. That's a very small portion. That's somewhere around 14 billion parameters out of the entire thing. That's the reason they call it as a sparse neural network and nothing fancy, right? And the reason for why it's not actually 8 into 7 is only the expert layers have the separate parameters. That is, each expert has its own parameters, while the rest of the network is shared among these experts. That's the reason we don't have 56 billion parameter model, rather we have a 47 billion parameter. And each expert is somewhere close to 12 billion. So when we do an inference, the model almost gives performance of a 12 billion parameter. This paper also discusses about how they were able to compete with Llama's 70 billion model, though it's a way smaller model. They were better than Google's Gemini model and GPT 3.5 Turbo. They compared it with GPT 3.5 Turbo. And there's also one more interesting thing which was that in the paper, which is routing analysis. So people, when Mistral came out, people were assuming that some of us were assuming that each of the expert would have specialized in some of the concepts, like probably one expert specializes in math, one expert specializes in probably deep learning, right? But that was not proved to be true in some of their analysis. There were some experts which probably learned some certain logics, but it was not a common pattern in the entire set of experts. If you look at historical papers also, that has been the theme. There were a few papers on MoE, which also claim that experts do not learn a special concept, which in a way also makes sense. We humans, though, have categorized our entire knowledge into a set of subjects, but we can see that there's a lot of overlap between all of these subjects, right? So, okay, the one more thing that they have done is there is a base model and there's also an instruction fine-tuning model. The instruction fine-tuning model, they took the base model and they trained it through SFT and DPO. I have not still looked into what are these. Probably when I look at them, I'll make another video on what exactly happens, demystify the code, and probably someday show you an example of how to fine-tune using your own Instruct data set. Hope you like this video. If you have any comments, please leave it in the suggestions. Thank you for watching. Bye-bye.